What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy Ninja Looter here, and I'm going to talk about this beautiful time vacuum of a video game called Clicker Heroes. Alright, so I can quickly and efficiently farm these hero souls through about 800 levels in around 35 minutes, which I think is pretty good for me at this point in my Clicker Hero career. So I'm going to show you guys what I do to maximize my efficiency here. I actively click. I use an auto clicker. And I like to use the crits to just pull down these mobs. So obviously the first thing that I'm going to go with is Ball. Ball is like the strongest DPS ancient that you can find. And the more you put into him, the better he gets. There's no maximum level. He just gets gnar after a while. After Ball, I always go with Juggernaut because, you know, when you're asleep, it's just cumulatively getting stronger. It's, 97, 100... It's just going. Those combos are just going up there. And your DPS just gets massive while you're sleeping or at work or whatever. So after those two DPS ones, I always go with Vogger. Vogger reduces the cooldowns of these bad boys right here, which, you know, the cooldowns without Vogger are brutal. You don't want to sit here for 20 minutes waiting for something to cool down. It's ridiculous. So you grab Vogger next. After that, you want to get the gold ancients, which are... Saw him. There he is. Mammon. You want Mammon next after that. That's every time gold drops, he gives a percentage to it, which is awesome. Then after him, you want to get Dora. Dora's, percentage towards gaining more chests. And then Mimsy is actually boosting the amount of gold coming out of those chests, which is good. Mo beta. We got Fortuna here, which, 10 times gold is 10 times better. You know, they just, you can't cut that. You want to hire a bunch of heroes fast, you're going to need 10 times the gold. It procs pretty efficiently. I like it. I didn't realize how, you know, valuable it was until I picked it up, maxed it out. And then I was like, how did I ever play the game without this thing? So after that, I like to get this Kuma Wakamaru, which is a weird name. And he just makes it to where you only have to kill 5 monsters every level instead of 10, which speeds you through stuff pretty efficiently. After that, I like to grab the two that reduce the boss's life and reduce the, you know, increase the time that you have to fight the boss. So I usually go with Kronos. Kronos, you can sit here forever and just hit that boss. I mean, 80 seconds. If you can't pull the boss down in 80 seconds, what are you doing? You know what I mean? Put your beer down. Upgrade your heroes. It's ridiculous. So after that, I go with Bubos. And, that's just higher in the levels, it gets more and more effective. 50% off of a... I think it's 50% when it's maxed out off of a boss. You know, when he's got, like, whatever the crazy number of hit points he has is. It's just massive. That's just damage you don't have to do anymore, which is awesome. So, after that, I like to max out the primal boss chance here, which is good. More primal bosses showing up is always better. And then, the amount that you get from the primal bosses. So, threw a bunch in there, and it's actually been pretty efficient. So, when I'm using my skills to get past a particularly hard boss or whatever, I like to go in this order. I like to use Energize, then I hit Power Surge, then I hit Dark Ritual, then I hit Reload to reduce the amount of time of Dark Ritual, then I hit Lucky Strikes, Power Surge, Click Storm, then Metal Detector and Golden Clicks, and I just let it ride after you hit Super Clicks, of course. And that melts everything. You'll have a good, like, 10 or 15, 20 levels of just everything getting blinked down in a second. You'll have a huge increase in the amount of gold that you have. And that kind of helps you push past those plateaus, those level barriers that they got set up in there. You know, maybe you need to upgrade your heroes a little bit more to get past a particularly hard boss or whatever. And that'll help you do it for sure. Of course, you want Masked Samurai to be as gilded as you could possibly get them. And how I'm doing it when I'm leveling up is I go all the way down to Frostleaf, and I put about 140 levels in Frostleaf. Then I come back up, and I start throwing them all into Masked Samurai. I buy all of the talents all the way across, but after I've already gone all the way down. It's so quick now at this level that I really don't need these skills to progress to the point where I can, you know, get Frostleaf and then start putting levels in a Masked Samurai. So I kind of just go all the way down, put 140 levels in Frostleaf, go back up to Masked Samurai, and toss some levels into him until, you know, the monsters start dying faster and faster and faster, and then I go back, I grab all the skills and stuff. And that's when it really gets good, though, because there are skills in here that give you plus to critical and then plus to critical chance as well. So, you know, it goes pretty fast, though. Usually I'm at, like, level 200 and something before I even start buying skills up here. So it goes fairly quickly. But, yeah, that's what I've been doing to get, on average, like 1,400, 2,000 hero souls per run. It only takes about 30, 35 minutes. So, yeah, hopefully that helps you guys out a little bit. Maybe you touched on something that you haven't heard before. I know Atlas is the second hero that you want to start putting levels into after you go to Masked Samurai and start just dumping levels in there. I usually go to Atlas once Masked Samurai is at about 2,200 hip, you know, levels or whatever. So at around 2,200 levels, I start dumping everything into Atlas. And Atlas is just a beast. You can check out my guilds here. I got 8 into Masked Samurai, 14 into Atlas. I should probably de-guild some stuff. I've been kind of lazy with it. To de-guild, you just hold the control down and left-click it, and his guild will go somewhere else randomly. And you just keep doing that until they go into the ones that you want, which is these two here. And once you get those, you know, beefed up, it's just massive damage from those two. But anyways, I hope that helps you guys out. If you like what you heard today, just hit that like button and subscribe, please. Talk to you guys later.